So how can we optimize these two terms over here? The idea is to use gradient descent. That is, every time step, we take a small step in the direction of minimizing the error over here. So here's the expression for the first objective. When we iterate, we assign to yi recursively the old yi, but we subtract a term that's proportional to the deviation of yi to xi, weighted by a weighting function alpha. That's not exactly the same alpha as before. And we set this alpha over here to 0.5. For the second term, we could implement this as follows, where we retain the old y variable, but we move a little bit into the direction of y plus 1, of yi plus 1, and away from yi. But an even better implementation looks as follows. This is combining the step on the left and the step on the right. Realizing that each yi occurs twice in this optimization term, one here and one here, we can now go and implement this in a single update rule where we wish yi to be as close to yi minus 1 and simultaneously be as close as yi plus 1 by optimizing this combined term. Think about this a little bit, but that's what I wanted to implement. And we're going to set better to 0.1. So now let's go and implement this. And as a last hint, I don't want you to apply this optimization for the first or the last node in the sequence. I want those to be unchanged, as we'll see in a second. So here's the code I'll be giving you. There's a path in a 5x5 grid starting at 0,0 to 4,4. And if you look very carefully, it goes to the right at first, then straight down, then to the right again. This is exactly the path we discussed so far. It looks like this graphically. I now want you to implement the function smooth, which takes as an input the path, our two weighting factors, and a small tolerance variable, which I explain you in a second. And it creates the new path, which are the y's in our equation so far, from the old path. This is a deep copy over here. And then below the line, I want you to implement the smoother. What the smoother does, it iteratively applies the two equations I just gave you to all nodes except for the first and the last. And it does so until the total change observed in the update step becomes smaller than tolerance, at which point we consider the smoother to have converged. So here's my command. I compute a new path as a result of the function smooth. And in your test, you should uncomment the new path smooth routine and the print routine that outputs my result. Thanks for Enter, a student who posted a much better way to output matrices on a discussion forum. So I'm going to use his code or her code. Thank you so much. And here's the result. After hitting run, I have the original path over here, 0 all the way to 4,4. The two initial and the end position should be the same as before, so please don't modify them. But in between, we get these interpolation positions over here. If you look at this, my original path didn't vary the axis at all for the first three steps, whereas this one goes from 0,0 to 0.17, so it got closer, so it went down a little bit. And also went less to the right side than my original path. That went all the way to 2 over here, to 1.8 over here. What this means is that our new points lie a little bit like this. And as you go through the list over here, you'll find that our new points really smooth out the path to something more like that.
Hi, I'm Andy, the assistant instructor for this class, and I just wanted to provide some clarification about how you're going to use gradient descent to minimize these functions. First, I'd like to point out that there was a slight error in the path used in Sebastian's code. That 4,4 that he was using should actually be replaced with a 4,2. Also, those minus signs that you saw here should actually be replaced with plus signs if we want this gradient descent implementation to converge. Finally, even though these yi's and xi's are two-dimensional vectors, when you implement your code, it may be easier to just iterate over each individual entry. So, for example, these xi's would be these values here.